Today we are talking about add-ons, things we can add onto our TRT.
Welcome to this channel. I am Dr. Steven De Vos, the lifting dermatologist, and this is my bro science hunting partner Danny Bossa. If you want to learn more about the most cutting-edge science-based information in the world of hormone optimization, please like and subscribe.
Click the bell button to get notified.
I also invite you to join my other YouTube channel, The Lifting Dermatologist. The link you can find in the description of this video.
Welcome to the video, everyone. My name is Dr. Steven De Vos. We are on the TRT and Hormone Optimization channel. For the first time here on the channel, I have as an honored guest Theo De Wet from the Netherlands. Welcome, Theo.
Hey, guys.
He has been on my other channel, The Lifting Dermatologist, before because he has given some lectures about anabolic steroids, but that was in his main language, Dutch. But this time around, he's going to give it in English because there's a lot of demand for that. So welcome, Theo, again. And today we are talking about add-ons, things we can add onto our TRT. So different anabolic compounds that could be or would be safe to use year-round. Okay, go ahead, Theo.
Hey, guys. First of all, sorry if I sound too Dutch in my English views, but I'll try my best. So, let's get started, I guess. First off, I will share the screen so that you guys can see. Like that and like... Come on. Yeah. So there we go, guys. So first of all, it's about the therapy purposes compound. So it's not revolted about all muscle building or having a leaner look or losing weight. It's all about helping you guys with your therapy, with TRT, and your joints or your libido or lowering your SHBG hormones so that your free testosterone gets higher. So it's also compounds you can use year round. Those are not liver toxic, or injectables, which are not liver toxic at all, of course. First of all, I have one of the best compounds in the world for lowering your SHBG hormones and so increasing your free testosterone and increasing your libido. If that goes up, your libido always goes up if your free testosterone goes up. So Provion is a DHT-derived compound, so that would mean possible hair loss and maybe a little bit of acne if you're genetically prone to those things. If not, you might have not a single zit or a pimple or whatever and not lose a single hair. But that's along the line. First of all, dosage. It's an oral compound and it's not liver toxic. So the dosage is it's made in 25 milligram tablets, sometimes in 50 milligram tablets on the underground markets and stuff, but just be careful with those. If you can get the Bayer Provion, that's the real pharmaceutical company, Bayer, it's a German company, those tablets will always be in 25 milligrams. If you use one or two a day, you can take them split throughout the day. So in the morning, 25 milligrams, and in the evening, 25 milligrams. But I'll always advise people to start off at 25 milligrams because 25 milligrams a day of Provion might actually drop your SHBG hormones by 40 or 50%. So that's a lot for a low dose. A few people I've coached in this they dropped from the absolute maximum of the SHBG concentrations in the blood to almost under the minimum amount. So their free testosterone shot up like crazy, and that was on 50 milligrams, but he also started at 25, and that lowered drastically, but he wanted to see what it would do on 50 milligrams a day. So can you use this year round? Yes, you can, because Provion is one of the only compounds in the world that you can take orally in the steroid world. that is not liver toxic at all, and that's because it's alkylated differently. Instead of the 17th alpha alkylated molecule, it's the first one. So somehow that makes it not liver toxic at all. So you can take that year round while on TRT, though. If you take that without TRT hormones, it will shut you down eventually. So you will have no testosterone to actually boost or free up. So only on TRT, but that's why we're here, of course. So the effects are in the lower corners. Higher libido, lower SHBG levels, and a bit of a leaner physique. That's because Proviron also binds to estrogen a bit. So it might lower your estrogen just a little tad. And it might give you a little of a bit of a lean physique. It's nothing you like you notice in the mirror, like bang, I'm suddenly a much leaner guy. But if you're already pretty lean, you might see some a vein here or there, or just a strand of muscle you can see a little bit better. So it might give you an added benefit of looking good in the mirror, looking good naked. So next up, I think Steven got a lot of questions about this one. Nandrolone and Decanoate. So in short, Deca. This one will have stopped production in the meantime. A few years, like 15 years ago, they stopped producing it, maybe even longer ago, because people were misusing it and it was a steroid. So people are afraid and don't really use that for therapeutic purposes. Maybe your doctor can get it somewhere, but the chances are that you have to get on the underground market or something, or know a guy, and get the Deca yourself. Usually, the doses of Deca in the actual vials or ampules vary from 75 milligrams per milliliter to sometimes even 500 milligrams per milliliter. So the volume you have to inject every week or every few days could differ from how much milligram per ml there is in that. But I guess you guys are smart enough to see that yourself. So the doses for joint relief, so that would be 50 to 75 milligrams a week. Could you go to 100? Yeah, you could. But keep in mind, every time you go up in a dosage of something like Deca, which is a steroid, if we're fair, every time we go up, it will give a little bit of a hit on your cholesterol. And cholesterol is, of course, very important for your health, for your heart health. So getting that up is not something you want, because it lowers the good cholesterol and it raises the bad cholesterol, LDL. So take the dosage that's the least possible, that gives you the most amount of benefits in TRT purposes, of course. Can use this year-round, so 52 weeks, given that it's the low dose of 50 to 75 milligrams a week. If you go higher sometimes, I would certainly don't use that year round in a high dose. Is it liver toxic? No, because it's an injectable. It is, though, if you go up in dosage, it could be toxic or bad for you, in the sense of maybe blood pressure rising, or like I said, the cholesterol values. And maybe even if you're genetically prone to that, prostate issues. But that's only on the higher doses. I've never seen any problems at 50 to 75 milligrams a week in anyone. Never. So that's something everyone could take on TRT if you have painful joints. Possible side effects are a bit of hair loss. It's lower than the chance of hair loss are much lower than on testosterone. So if you don't have that on testosterone, chances are you will never have that on nandrolone, because it converts into a different kind of hormone, converts into DHN instead of DHT, and DHT is the is one of the main causes of hair loss, and DHN is much weaker. So on the actual hair follicles, so that might not actually be a thing for you. And if you're really prone, if your skin is very oily or something, you might get a bit of acne. But that's just because I want it out there. But on that dose, probably no acne, no hair loss, probably no problems at all, instead of also just the nice side effects, the nice effects of it as a hormone itself. So in short, it will give you nice and lubricated joints, stronger tendons, and maybe a little bit of extra strength in the gym. You might get ridiculous pumps in the gym if you're into that kind of thing, because it might do some positive things into your nitrogen retention or water retention. So it's not a lot, but it's just in the muscle. So it might give you a ridiculously nice pump in the gym. So that's also added benefit. So yeah, that's a really, really, really good compound if you have some painful joints or stiff joints or whatever. Helps for every kind of joint. If it's a knee joint, ankle joint, shoulder joint, your back is hurting up. Danny Bossa made a video on it with you, Steven. So yeah, I watched that video and I'm happy he also likes DECA. It's one of my favorites.
But he was taking 200 milligrams a week, and you consider that a high dose, right?
Yeah, he started out on 200 because it would peak in the blood values a little bit. And then he went to 100 milligrams, I think.
Okay.
So, well, if it's 100 milligrams, if it's an underground lab, like he said, usually it's a bit underdosed. So we would be about 75 or 80 milligrams a week. And that's also fine. If it's actually 100 milligrams, that's a big difference. That's 25% difference. So that's a big jump. So try to stay under that 100 milligrams. But if it's an underground market lab, you could go 100, because usually it's not actually 100 milligrams. It's less. So you'll still be safe then. And then the last one, you could see Primobolan as kind of an injectable Proviron. And yeah, if you're just not a pill guy, like I don't like popping pills or taking pills everywhere. I just like to inject myself once or twice a week. Twice a week would be better. And if you're doing your TRT shots, why not add a little bit of Primobolan if you have the money for that and the wish for that. So if you're not a pill guy, just do injectables if that's your thing. I could understand. I don't personally have a problem with taking a pill, but I guess it could be an annoyance to take pills around everywhere if you go to sleep somewhere else or have a hotel and always have to bring your Proviron. So that could be a thing if you don't like doing that. So Primobolan is really, really good at being low in side effects and still having benefits. A thing I didn't add here is that it's actually, it could be really beneficial for the regeneration of your skin, just like Anavar. So if you have skin problems and it doesn't give you an oily skin or acne, it might actually improve your skin. So that's an added benefit, I guess. So the dosage of Primobolan is usually 100 to 200 milligrams per ml. Sometimes you see 250 milligrams per ml. I do advocate for the enanthate ester. You also have the acetate ester, so that's a really short one. But because you will be some kind of pincushion, because you have to inject that every single day, because the blood levels will fluctuate too much. I would certainly do twice a week injections of about 100 or 125 milligrams of Primobolan enanthate if you want to use this. And you can use this year round. It's not liver toxic because it's an injectable. It's also one of the very safest anabolic steroids in the world. It was used on kids. It was used on women. And in the doses of which we're talking about, they were no side effects at all. Kids started growing, of course. Muscle started growing, but at one point they used Primobolan to actually kickstart puberty. In some guys that didn't actually start puberty on their own. So highly likely they were on TRT for the rest of their lives, but that's not a thing that you should worry about, I guess. It's not a bad thing. Yeah, a bit of hair loss if you're prone. The side effects on Primobolan are very, very low, and the chances on it of it are very low. So it does lower your SHBG, like providing us a little bit less in the in how actively it does that. It does have some kind of estrogen controlling effect, not to the extent of Proviron, but that's a completely different hormone, of course. So it will lower SHBG, so it will rise your raise your libido, it will raise your free testosterone. And since it's an anabolic steroid, 200 to 250 milligrams a week will probably give you a little bit of strength in the gym, some endurance in the gym, so more reps, more more gas in the tank, basically. So so it might actually give you a fair bit of gains throughout the year, of course. It's not something you snap your fingers and have a half a kilogram of weight on you. It just... it's a steady amount of gains on through the year. So I think that's it. That's my last last slide. There are things you could take throughout the year, but not every day of the year. You have to pause that. You could take an Anavar or something, but that's not really TRT related. You can do mini cycles of that, but we're talking about the TRT and actually helping to be healthy and free of pain instead of cycling any other compound. So
okay,
that's something for a different video, I guess.
With these three, Proviron, Deca and Primo, are there any other things people have to worry about when they add them to their TRT, like estrogen, prolactin issues with Deca, for example?
In those kind of doses from 50 to 75 milligrams a day, I wouldn't even think about adding prolactin decreases. If you can get them, like Pramipexol or something, it's good to have it on hand just in case you are very very responsive to that. I think nobody would in that kind of dosage, but you might actually be that 1% or 0.5% of the world that actually has that. So having it on hand is not a bad thing, of course. If there's a little bit of extra money, you should. If someone is very, very, very estrogen prone, so if you have maybe gyno on your TRT dose, Deca might not be the best choice for you. But if you can keep the estrogen of your TRT under control, then I see no problem adding Deca in it, since you can just up your anti-estrogen just a little tad, because it's not something something else than estrogen. It's not progesterone that increases; it's just estrogen, and you can keep it under control just a little bit higher dose of your anti-estrogen.
Mm-hmm.
So, okay. Not really something to worry about now.
Okay, Theo, thank you so much for this wonderful lecture.
Yeah. I hope the English was not too Dinglish or Dutch English, as we say it here. So I'll see the questions, I guess, on your channel.
Okay, was great. Thank you.
Okay, bye-bye, man.